skin cancer is a scourge. There's sort of very, very sharply increasing trends in skin cancer rates across our country. So skin cancer are the most numerous cancer types. If in the United States there are maybe about 3.5 to 4 million cancers total a year, about a third of them are all skin cancers. We've learned a lot about the genetic basis of disease by studying the genetic risk factors for skin cancer. And they go far beyond just looking at just the color of someone's skin, looking at various aspects of DNA repair and the genetic code that influence how much one person might be susceptible to cancer and the rays of the sun. Then we're also looking at environmental risk factors, such as use of tanning beds, we're looking at time spent in the sun. But it seemed that there was something missing. We ended up doing some work looking at the association between people consuming citrus at certain quantities in their regular lives and their risk of cancer in the future. And what we found was that there was an increased risk of melanoma, about a 30% increased risk of melanoma. Turns out that citrus, lime juice, lemon juice, grapefruit juice, orange juice, all contain rich amounts of naturally occurring substances called furocumarins. And furocumarins make you burn the sun. So it'd probably be okay to consume citrus in the afternoon once the sun's further lower down on the horizon so you don't get enough sun exposure and then it gets metabolized in your system overnight. Early morning citrus intake right before you're about to get sun exposure all day is probably not a good idea. In the US today, there is no single well-accepted and agreed-upon protocol for skin cancer screening. Fortunately, our department here at Brown leads internationally in the area of skin cancer prevention. So there are a couple of ways we can prevent cancer. One is obviously screening. The other is what we call chemo prevention. And now they can come to us right here and Brown affiliated faculty are able to care for them. As you begin these research efforts, it takes a few years. And I think we're just beginning to now realize the fruits of that investment. I think the future lies really in our ability to identify and train the best and brightest in these dual worlds of clinical care and research.